welcome back to my channel. It's your girl Amina, and as you can tell from the title below, this is a reorganising my bookshelves video because I ordered some new bookshelves. Woo! As you can tell from over here, the brown packaging, these are my new bookshelves. They are the Billy bookshelves from IKEA because I decided that I no longer want my units, I want proper bookshelves. So what's happening is these units are going and I'm giving them to a friend because I thought might as well give them to someone who actually wants them and will go to a nice loving home. So yes, because these shelves have done me justice these last few years, but unfortunately I'm getting rid of them. So I don't know how long this video is going to be. So the plan today is I'm going to be taking off the books off the units first, placing the books on the bed and on the floor, then taking the units downstairs because my friend's going to come and collect them tomorrow, and then build the Billy bookshelves and then put the books on the shelves and reorganize them and see where I want certain books and stuff. So yes, I'm really, really excited. I know I'm gonna have to end up taking down some of my posters and placing them somewhere else because the Billy bookshelves are high, so, and I don't want them overshadowing my posters, especially my fairy tale poster, which I'm so proud of. So I'm going to reorganize a little bit of my wall space, but other than that, I'm really excited, so let's get straight into the video. Bye guys. So, I have gotten rid of the small unit that's out on the landing. I'll be taking that downstairs soon enough. But I have moved the tall unit there so I can build one bookshelf there. I'm also going to be able to remove that now, which is good. But take a look at this, right? So I have removed, what, two shelves of books from there and then four from the small unit. And that is basically just covering the entirety of my bed. Can you believe that? Like, oh damn, that is a lot of books. Like, I forget how many books I have when they're on the shelves because it doesn't look like much. But when you place them out on the bed and on the floor, that's like a lot of books. It's a lot of books. Hope once I've built the bookshelf to put there, I'm gonna be able to take this off, which is good, and then that'll leave more space for the bed, so I can put more books on the bed. But yes, this is what it looks like so far. Kind of chaotic, but I'm okay with that. Look how dirty these windows are. So dirty. I tell you what, after I've done the bookshelves, I'm going to clean these windows. Windows? Mirrors! Oh my god. Oh my god. Wow. I just said windows instead of mirrors. Yeah, look at all these smudges. Damn. Dirty. But yeah, so we have made some progress, which is really, really good. I'm actually really excited to start building the new bookshelf, so let's get down to it. Okay, everyone, so I have put up the first bookshelf. That was tough. Look at it. It's here. It's so much slimmer than my units. I mean, look how slim that is and how much space I've got there now. Before, my units came to around where the curtain was. So I didn't have that much space there, but now it's a lot more slimmer. Oh, I'm so excited. I'm so excited to start putting my books up. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is to build the next bookshelf, but I'm not gonna film that because it's just a rigorous process of you, like, you guys watching me build it twice. But because there's limited room in my room to build the second bookshelf, I'm gonna build it downstairs and then haul it up the stairs and put it in my room that way. And then what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna organize my books and rearrange my books and put them on the bookshelves. But that part I will be filming, which you will be able to see. But yeah, okay. I'm gonna go downstairs, start making the second bookshelf. Yay! Okay, let's get going. Okay, so I've officially finished making the bookshelves and they are up. You guys ready to see them? Here we go. Look at those beauties. Oh, I'm already in love and I haven't even put the books on yet. Okay, so next step is to do all the books. One of these books, as you can tell. But I think it's past 4 o'clock, so I need to feed the dog first and do some washing up for my mum, because I don't want her to come home to a messy house. So I'm gonna do that first, and then after that, we are doing the books. Yee! All right, so I have done the washing up downstairs. I have fed the animals, the units are up. Now, the last thing to do is sorting out all these books. Ow, my hand. So yes, and all the trinkets as well and everything. Ooh, okay, this is gonna be interesting. This is gonna be really, really interesting. Let's get into it, yeah?
Ooh.
finished. I have finally finished. When I say finished, I mean finished. The only thing that I have to do now is find places in my room where I can hang up the posters and the pictures that I took down. But besides that, I am done. That took all day, but I'm absolutely in love. Look at my new bookshelves. I absolutely love them. I love them so much.
Okay, so at the top I've just got my little trinkets and mugs and little like statues. Nothing too major. And there's Bakugo and Midoriya. Then on my first shelf I've got my Cassandra Clare books. There's those, and again some trinkets. And then on this side I have got my Sergio Mas and Leah Bardugo, again with some trinkets. Those there are, I can't remember what they're called now. They're things for witches, basically. Witch stones, that's it, witch stones. So that's that shelf. Then on the second shelf, I have got my Percy Jackson books, my Scuderia Pleasant books, and then I have got 100, and then just these ones that I need to carry on with. Second part, I have got the Witcher series, Lion, the Witch and the Wardrobe, my Shadow Black series. I actually adore this series so much, by Sebastian de Castiel. Is it de Castel or de Castiel? I always say Castiel for some reason. Then I've got the Inquisitor books, then Ember in the Ashes. Ember in the Ashes, sorry. The Shadow Magic Trilogy and Children of Blood Magic. So that's that shelf. If you can see, there's a theme of like higher fantasy, meaning it's all like in different worlds, except obviously the Narnia series, but I think it just goes well with the colour. Then my third shelf is my Harry Potter collection here. Now I no longer follow JK Rowling. I do not support her at all. I don't like how she's trying to write a book about that's got transphobia in it. Hell no. However, this collection here was my grandfather's, and I bought this collection when I was 16. So because I spent so much money on these, I am keeping them. I do love the story, but I'm no longer going to spend any more money on JK Rowling, because that way I'd be supporting her, and I do not want to support her. I've also got Luna Lovegood's wand there. I'm not going to get any more wands either. No more Harry Potter merchandise for me, unfortunately. Well, not unfortunately, I'm kind of happy because I do not support her at all. Not anymore. But this. Then I've got Lev Grossman's The Magician series following. It's basically like Harry Potter, except it's college. It's basically magic at school. Same with the Dragonstone series here. One of my friends wrote this series. They're still writing it, so I'm supporting them, and obviously, and I really enjoy their books. It's like Harry Potter, but it's got its own spin on it. I might do a video on that a different time. Then I got my Rainbow Rowell, Wayward Son and Carry On, purely because it is a school of magic, like this theme of the shelf, so I thought might as well put it on here. And then the Crave book, because again it's school, instead of a school of magic there, it's a school of monsters, but still school of supernatural, so that's for that theme. Then got a little wizard here holding a little marble up, which I really think suits the theme of the shelf. Then on this side, I have got the Cruel Prince series. I need to get the third installment to the series. I haven't read that one yet. Then I've got Holly Black. So basically, this is Holly Black here. Then I've got Sarah Holland. I love this duology so very, very much. Then I've got Christelle Dabos. Don't know if I'm pronouncing that right. I need to get the third book to that. Then I've got Victoria Aveyard with the Red Queen series. My little I've got my Kindle here, but a little cute place to put it. Then I've got my VE Schwab little area, again with the darker shade of magic little collection there, which is going on. I think it looks really, really cute. And then that's that shelf. I've got a little potion bottle here. Then on the fourth shelf down, I've got my Mortal Instruments series right there. Then I've got the Maze Runner series. It's because I was looking at the Scorch Trials book. Then I've got Hush Hush. Then the Darker Days Pact. Nope, sorry, Darker Days Club. That's in the wrong order, but I'll fix that in a second. Then I've got Delirium. And then just little ones here. And my comics here. Then on my second part of my fourth shelf, then here I've got my Anna Todd books. Yes, you can judge me. Yes, you can shame me. I'm okay with it. I like this series. I do. Is it a great series? No. Are there other books that I prefer to the After series? Yes. But for a good, like, dirty binge read, I always go for the After books. So I need to get the fourth one because I haven't read the one yet, but that can go right there. Then I've got The Diviners, Noughts and Crosses, which is of the Discovery Witches. Shadow Me, so these ones are basically like the books, the starting off series, because I need to get the rest of the series, same with Shadow Me. Then I've got my Wolfspring Chronicles books here, these three, this trilogy. Now, these aren't amazing books, unfortunately, but these were this was the first series I ever read, and I was in love with them as a kid. If you're into bad writing but still like Twilighty but with werewolves and just werewolves instead, I highly recommend these. They're like the good trash that you want to read. Then I've got these books here. I've got the Rachel Cain Glass House ones, then Daughter of the Pirate King and Beautiful Creatures. And then I've got the Vampire Academy the Vampire Academy series here. So that's that shelf. And then I've got a little elephant here, and then some crystals and stones here. Then on my fifth shelf down, this whole shelf and that one over there is basically like fantasy for adult. Well, mostly I can say. So this is all fantasy for adult here. And then I've got some fantasy for adult here. I just need to fix this a little bit. And then I've got my J.R.R. Tolkien, because everyone needs a bit of hobbits in their lives and dwarves. I've got a little Miles Morales. Is that his last name? I forgot his last name from Spider-Verse. And I've got a little plushie of a Harley Quinn. That's that shelf. My last shelf, all this shelf here, is contemporary until it meets up to around here, which is a little bit of fantasy. I didn't know where else to put these, unfortunately, so I just put them down here. But most of this is all contemporary. And on this shelf, I've got a little snow globe of dolphins that I got when I was in Tenerife, because that's where originally I come from. And then I've got a little Deadpool bobblehead, because I love Deadpool. Then on this shelf is very random, I guess. I mean, on this side of the shelf, it's all like classics and like to do with like history, as you can tell. And then on this side, it's just more like random and what I can fit on and everything. So there's that. And then I've got a little Joker here, a little roundhead Joker. And then a little cat strapped into a basket there. And that is that shelf. And at just the side of my bookshelves, I've got my little witch books, just because I've got nowhere else to put them. And I've got my a dark shade of magic stuff here, including the posters that I need to put up as well. So, but that's just that little nook there. That is all done. I'm really happy with the setup. I don't normally have themes or plans to go to when it comes to putting all my books. I just kind of put them where I like them best, and I just kind of go with it. And I'm really liking the way it's set up, to be honest. I think it looks really, really cool. I'm so happy. Oh my God, I love them so, so, so much. I've got a little bit of extra space on this side of the bed over here. And it just looks so neat and so tidy. And I'm just really, really happy with the outcome of it all. So that took the entire day.
But you know what? It's kind of okay because we kind of started around 12:30-ish now, and I think it's nearly 5 o'clock. So yeah, it's nearly 5 o'clock. No, it's just gone past five. It's nearly 5:30. So it's nearly 5:30. So done 5.5 hours. Not bad, to be honest, I think, for setting this all up. I mean, with one small girl like me and doing all of this, I think I've done good. To be fair, though, my arm is hurting. My arm is hurting. But besides that, I'm really happy with the outcome. I'm really loving it. My old shelves, my units, are out on the landing. My friend is coming tomorrow to come and collect them, so they are his to have. But they're taking a bit of space on the landing, but hopefully by tomorrow they're going to be gone. So yeah, all in a day's work, I guess. Thank you so much for watching my video and for kind of just going along with it. I mean, I'm a mess, I'm chaotic, this has kind of become the theme of my YouTube channel now. I'm not sure if I'm a booktuber, just a chaotic YouTuber. I'm okay with that. So I guess that's it for the video. Thank you so much for coming along with the ride and for watching me on my craziness. Honestly, it means a lot. Had a bit of a dance around today, had a bit of fun. It's all been good. So thank you so much for watching. Please don't forget to like the video, comment down below, and don't forget to subscribe and push the notifications bell. I always have trouble saying that. Oh well. Bye guys. Have a great day.